evening. This is 461 Sports Center, and I'm J. Robert Saunders. Welcome. Our top story of the night, women's basketball. UBC women's basketball team taking on California State of Pennsylvania. Barn burner, 21-19. UBC pulling out the win. We're going to go to our field reporter, Alicia Dorsch.
Yeah, hi.
How'd you feel about the game today?
Oh, well, like, I gave 110%. The girls were, like, really giving their all out there. It was really great. Like, we won, which is really awesome.
Sorry to go down on that last play. How are you feeling?
I'm in a lot of pain right now, and I don't really know what's wrong. Like, I really hope I'm not out for the season, because that'd be really sad.
Well, there you have it. Back to you in the newsroom, Gareth.
Stellar interview, Alicia.
We're going to go take a look at Shanice's ACL tear here. And down she goes.
Oh, no. Now, let's get on with the presentation.
ACL, isn't that, like, in your shoulder?
Are you stupid? It's in your nose.
Oh!
It rubs some jam
on it!
It's cold jam.
Oh.
Cold jam.
No peanut butter.
No peanut butter, that makes it worse.
It does.
Yeah.
ACL injuries occur most frequently in sports involving pivoting and sudden deceleration. The incidence rate for ACL injuries in females versus males is 2.4 to 9.7 times higher. Most often, ACL injuries occur with MCL, meniscus tear, and bone marrow lesions. There are over 200,000 ACL reconstructions per year in the US. The typical features of the history are the patient often describes a pop, crack, or feeling of something going out and then going back. And most complete ACL tears are extremely painful. Usually sports people or athletes are unable to continue their activity. And if the sports person tries to recommence the sporting activity, they feel instability or lack of confidence in the knee. Upon examination, the clinician will find restricted knee range of movement due to a tense hemisthrosis, widespread mild tenderness, lateral joint tenderness, and medial joint line tenderness if an associated medial meniscus injury is there. Welcome to Channel 461. We are on location at Alan McGavin Physiotherapy Clinic at War Memorial Gym, where the injured player is doing her rehabilitation after a torn ACL. Today we have a panel of specialists with us here to talk about surgery versus non-surgical rehabilitation after an ACL injury. First we have Shanice Nolan.
Dr. Shanice Nolan.
Yes, and she is a sports medicine doctor who specializes in surgery for a torn ACL. Next we have Angela Pettit, who's going to talk to us about the consequences of both surgery and conservative methods of treatment. Finally, we have Victoria Gorodetsky, who is here to talk with us about conservative treatment. We're gonna first start talking with Dr. Shanice Nolan, who is here to talk to us about surgical reconstruction of a torn ACL. Now, the optimal treatment of the torn ACL is not known, and there are several areas of controversy regarding the management of ACL injuries. What can you tell us about the aim of surgical reconstruction of a torn ACL?
I can definitely tell you the aim.
of ACL reconstruction. The aim of the ACL reconstruction is to replace the torn ACL with a graft that reproduces the normal kinetic functions of the ligament that was once there. In most cases, an autogenous graft taken from around the knee joint is what is normally used.
Okay. Yes. And so how does one decide whether to do this surgery or not? What are some of the factors that could influence surgery?
There are many factors that influence whether or not someone should have ACL reconstructive surgery. So a couple of these factors include the age of the patient, the degree of the instability in function. Can they walk even? Are they still functional? Some people are actually functional with torn ACLs. Are there associated knee injuries? Like, is it just the ACL that is torn, or are there meniscal tears? Is it the MCL, the LCL? Lots of other things can be torn. Or the patient's desire to return to that jumping or pivoting sport. That is very important too.
And what about what they're doing in their day-to-day life? Does that play a factor at all?
Yes, there is. Well, like, of course, like, how about their occupation? Do they sit at a desk all day, or could they be police or firefighters and have to move all day every day?
Right, so all those play a factor.
Yes.
So who makes the decision of whether to have surgery or not?
The decision is usually made with not only the athlete or person with the torn ACL, but everyone involved. This includes the family, the patient themselves, the doctor, the physiotherapist, everyone who's involved.
All right, and now can you give us an idea of what surgery actually entails?
I would love to. That's my thing, I'll tell you. So there's many techniques. ACL tears are usually in-substance tears and therefore not suitable for primary repair. Reconstruction of the ACL is surgical. And ACL reconstruction is performed arthroscopically through small incisions in the knee. Arthroscopic surgery utilizes small incisions to help visualize inside the joint itself and facilitate tunnel placement of the graft. Depending on the type of graft, incisions to harvest the graft and secure tunnel access for graft fixation are made as well.
And are there more than one type of graft?
Yes, there is. There's allograft and autograft.
And what, can you give me a description?
Of course, okay. In simplest terms, I could say autograft is actually taken from a cadaver. So someone who has passed, we take tendons from their body and replace your torn ACL. Or allograft is taken from your body itself, either from your patellar tendon or your hamstring tendon, actually.
All right, yeah. Well, there you have it. Thanks, Shanice.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
Could you tell us some of the consequences of having an ACL reconstructive surgery and how that might affect an individual's decision of which route to go?
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. There are quite a few consequences for that. I don't know if you've done your research, but you can suffer from patella pain syndrome on either the injured or the uninjured side because you're going to be on crutches for so long. Be having a tight IT band or lateral retinaculum. Your glutes are going to go from that inactivity. You got your VMO is going to go as well.
So what does VMO stand for?
Your vastus medialis oblique. You should know that. You're a doctor.
I do. It was a test. Continue.
You can also get some low back pain as well, also caused from using the crutches. You're going to get some lower limb stiffness from not weight bearing for so long. You can also, depending on the individual, whether you do a thorough assessment beforehand, see how their soft tissue is either stiff or quite lax. You can do a bilateral comparison for that. If it is stiff, then you're not gonna wanna be in a brace for so long because there's gonna be excess scar tissue. And if that happens, the athlete's gonna have a really hard time getting that full extension after surgery, so they're probably gonna have to get surgery again in order to go back in and re-scope it and get all the damage out, you know?
Giving me business, right?
And it is true that range of motion is quite important post-surgery.
It is. Very.
You would think.
But then on the other hand, if they have quite lax ligaments, then you're going to want to keep them in the brace for longer so you do ensure that they have enough scar tissue growth.
Great. Well, there you have it, the consequences of ACL reconstructive surgery. Finally, we have the Victoria Gorodetsky talking to us about conservative treatment. Can you give us a description of what this entails?
Well, Alicia, this entails a specific rehabilitation program, and our findings from our studies have found that people with an acute ACL tear who undergo reconstruction and rehabilitation don't have any better outcomes than people who actually have just rehabilitation programs. Therefore, we don't have to do so many ACL reconstructive surgeries. We can avoid all the complications of surgery.
And Angela, can you talk to us about some of the specific consequences of taking this reconstructive path?
Absolutely. Unfortunately, since you're not going to be doing surgery, you're probably going to miss out on any other damage inside because you won't be in there with an arthroscope. So lots of people say you should still have an arthroscopy so you can see if there's any meniscal damage or anything. You're also going to have persistent pain and swelling because it's not fully healing. It's going to be a slower progression because, again, you're not actually reconstructing and fixing the ACL. Down the line, you could develop arthritis. And again, you're going to be at risk for further trauma and possibly the unhappy triad, which is also hurting your meniscus and spraining your MCL.
Well,
so
patients keep with that surgery mind. Always develop arthritis. So we got that one.
Oh, you got that in writing?
Yeah, our studies.
Mm-hmm.
Great. We'll end this there. Thanks so much to all of our three panelists.
We discussed it in class.
For coming out here and talking to us. The majority of ACL tears occur in a non-contact situation when the athlete is landing from a jump, pivoting, or decelerating suddenly.
I say surgery.
I say rehab.
Okay, well, we can like
compromise a little.
Kind of do both, but
okay.
Definitely surgery.
Okay, let's do both.
Definitely
we'll
surgery.
Do both.
Well, I made a pretty sick video about this rehab. I think you should check it out. ¶¶